Hi students, coming to the next type of operating system, that is a personal computing system. A personal computing system is nothing but your personal laptop. So what you are installing in your personal laptop, how the operating system is working in your personal computing system. So in main, in personal computing system, you call this is a single user system because you are using the system, so that you call it as a single user system. Your personal laptops are the single user system and it is always portable. So that is the first thing. And next, so in this personal computing system, there are I/O devices will be present, input output devices. So what are the I/O devices that are present in your personal computer? The I/O devices are keyboards, mouse, display screen means the monitor, you call it, it is a display screen, and small printers, etc. So these are the some of the I/O devices that are present in your personal computer. So what are the personal computing systems? So different types of personal computing system. So those are the laptops, smart cards, or you can take some wireless devices. So all these that are used in your home, those are the personal computing system, wireless devices. So if a single person is using any of the gadgets, that you call it as a personal computing system. So whatever the laptop that you are using, that is a personal computing system. And the smart cards and the wireless devices that you are using, means those are not connected in the networking. Okay, so just your system is connected to some wireless routers or whatever it may be. So that is also called as a personal computing system. A system that just communicating to another, means that you call it as a personal computing system. And next, a single user, so if you take a single user system, may not need advanced CPU utilization or protection features. So when compared to the other batch systems or other operating systems, your personal computing system need not require some advanced features of the CPU utilizations, advanced CPU utilizations and protection features. Why your systems is not that much of requirement is not needed? Because you are the only person who is using the system. So if your systems is connected in the network, so then obviously a CPU utilization has to be increased, the advanced technology has to be increased for CPU utilization, as well as some protection features has also to be increased if your personal computing system is connected in network. So when you're going for a single user system, so may not, the single user system may not need advanced CPU utilization and protection features. Now let us see what are the advantages of using this personal computing system. So the main advantages of using this personal computing system is user convenience. The main thing is user convenience. And here the responsiveness is also more when compared to other operating systems. So this is about the personal computing system. Thank you.